skies shall light the way, and blood shall spill over the wandering world. The spear of Cain shall call the wayfarers, and the storm prince shall unite them. Their victory shall shake the heavens. Hordes threaten to overrun planet Cyprus. Yet, by order of the Imperial Commander, Inquisitor Holt, reinforcements were kept in high orbit and forbidden from landing upon the planet. Leaving the Knights of House Varlok on their own to defend against the rampage. Help arrived when the Blood Ravens descended from the sky. Inquisitor's blockade and came to the aid of House Varlok.
Brothers, rise! We have orcs to kill! For the Emperor!
The Inquisitor was not pleased. Battlefield, planet Cyprus was littered with the wreckage of the armies and war machines that had contended there. To most, it was a scarred wasteland. But for the orcs, it was a rich bounty of valuable scrap. The orc Gorguts came to Cyprus to avail himself of these riches, and pledged his allegiance to one of the local war bosses. But few believed that he would be satisfied being a servant for very long. The Eldar warlord, Kaya, was obsessed with the prophecy of Cain, and sent his army to Cyprus to await the re-emergence of the wandering world. But Kaya's army met unexpected resistance from the local orcs. Kaya sent the Farseer Maka to assist his forces. Based upon her auguries, Maka did not trust the prophecy. And suspected there were sinister forces at work. Their fates seemingly intertwined, Maka and Angelos faced each other, their history lingering between them. Once they had been allies, an entente that was split by betrayal, and now, on this day, they were enemies. Maka under orders from Kaya to kill Angelos. The battle was to be short-lived and inconclusive. For on that day, at the same time as they struggled, Acheron, the wandering world of the Eldar prophecy, emerged from the warp after 5,000 years. Sun's arrival rained fiery debris on Cyprus, and as an errant spire impacted between them, Farseer Maka came to understand that she was now part of larger events that were unfolding around her. These events would spill the blood of legions, and would yet have a role for Gabriel Angelus. Gorguts and Kaia's armies clashed ferociously before the gate to the Altar of the Spear, seeking to secure their master's claim to the weapon. Unbeknownst to the warriors below, Inquisitor Holt, unable to take possession of the spear, sought to preclude anyone from obtaining it, and indiscriminately unleashed his powerful orbital cannon on the armies below.
Comes to pass. The way is open.
But the bombardment had consequences unforeseen by the Inquisitor, smashing the gate to the altar and opening the way to the spear. To Kaia, this was no accident, but the prophecy coming to pass.
Together, we can finally see.
Farseer Maka divined that the prophecy and the spear and the entire enterprise were an elaborate trap. Even then, the spear of Cain, for which so much blood had been spilled, lay within reach of those that sought it. Gorguts arrived first, but Kaia challenged him. And in a swift battle, vanquished him. In his moment of ascendant victory, trap was sprung on Kaia, and it was his blood that was spilled by the spear. It was not the weapon of an Eldar god, but a trinket to lure us like lambs to a blood sacrifice. A ritual to revive an ancient evil and unleash him from the ice. Released from dormancy and engorged with blood, the demon arose. The impact of the ship shattered the mantle of Acheron, smashing it into a multitude of fragments. Those that did not find means to escape perished. Though reduced in stature, The demon was not killed. And the core of his dominion remained. Demon defeated and the prophecy broken. The alliance was dissolved and the wayfarers went their separate ways.
At least I got my point of stick.